Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the inaugural Six Sundays in Spring concert for Spring 2019, featuring Buckshot Betty. I'm Bill Kokas. I'm the Vice President of Arts Wake Forest, and I just have a few announcements here from myself and the town, and then we will get things rolling. First, let me introduce you to Ruben, who's with the town, and he has a few announcements to make as well.
Good afternoon. I am Ruben Wall, the director for the Wake Forest Parks Recreation and Cultural Resource Department. That's me. I want to welcome you to the start of the 2019 Six Sundays concert series. And also, I want you to look over my head, please. Finally, we got the cover for the amphitheater. Amazing, amazing work. I want to recognize you, the citizens, who said, we need something like this. I want to recognize the commissioners and the mayor. Mayor Jones is here for providing the resources to make this happen. So Mayor Jones, thank you. She's in the back. And so now we do have a cover. There's also an art piece to this cover. When the concert's over, you may be able to get a chance to come up and see the lighting that's under the cover here, and it shines down onto the base here in the evening. So there's an art piece to this cover. Thank you again for coming out. I hope you enjoy your afternoon here. We've got staff in the back who've got any questions, and I'm gonna turn it over to Suja Jacobs. She is our special events coordinator, and she's got some more announcements to share with you.
Hi, everyone. I just wanna share with you a couple of other awesome events we have here right at Joyner during the month of May. In May, it is our May month of fitness. So on Mondays, there will be Camp Gladiator. On Tuesdays, yoga. Wednesdays, Zumba. And they're all will be right here at 6:30, so make sure you join us. We also have movie nights starting. The first movie will be May 25th, Incredibles 2. So make sure you come out for that. And we also have our midday music concert series starting May 9th, which is a Thursday, and we'll be featuring Big Bang Boom. It's a children's band, and if you have little kiddos, make sure you bring them out. It'll be lots of fun. And that is at Town Hall in the Rotunda. And just a few housekeeping. Please make sure your dogs stay on the leash. There's no smoking. The restrooms are located in the back. And make sure you visit our food vendors. We have the VFW Chuck Wagon, Marfa's Empanadas, Burger 21, Lumpy's, and Kona Ice. So make sure you visit them. And that's all I have for today.
Thank you, Suja. I just have a few more, not to be outdone. I wanted to tell you a little bit about Arts Wake Forest, the group that's putting on this show for you, for free. For more than 25 years, Arts Wake Forest has promoted the arts in Wake Forest by producing arts events and assisting emerging artists and arts organizations. We are an all-volunteer organization supported by donations from individuals and businesses. And you can stop by our booth, which is the first tent up there on the left, to see how you can volunteer or donate to support our work. During intermission, volunteers from Arts Wake Forest will be out in the crowd with blue buckets. We call this our Bucket Brigade, and please donate to continue these free concerts. We have a few upcoming events as well. Suja just mentioned Music at Midday, which is our weekly music series, Lunchtime Thursday at Town Hall, starting May 9th. And Neck of the Woods is a showcase for local artists and performers. Our next show will be July 19th, 7 p.m. at the Renaissance Center. And contact us for that if you're interested in performing, because we have not set the lineup for that yet. The Wake Forest Dance Festival will be here in September. It is a one-day, free, open-to-the-public, family-friendly event, Saturday, October 5th, at here under the cover. The event will feature regional, national, and international professional dancers, along with local Rising Advanced dance performers. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Arts Wake Forest, Town of Wake Forest, Parks, Rec, and Cultural Resources, Allen Tate Realty, the Wake Forest Rollsville Office, the Wege Foundation, United Arts of Raleigh, and Wake County. And you can stop by and visit them as well on the way out or sometime during the show. Our volunteers came from the Wake Forest Women's Club, the American Legion, Post 187 is handling our parking, and we have student volunteers from Wake Forest High School. And now, Buckshot Betty is a six-piece Americana outfit from Raleigh with roots spreading throughout the southeastern United States. They blend traditional country music with elements of bluegrass, Cajun, blues, and southern rock to form their own unique brand of Carolina country. Whether you're in the mood for a barnyard stomp, a fiddle waltz, or a mandolin float down the Kalachoo River, you'll find it here. Fronted by vocalist Kim Betty, Buckshot Betty also features Todd Betty, Dan Betty, Hollerin' Pat Betty, sharing duties on guitar, bass, dobro, mandolin, banjo, and the rare country ukulele, and Susanna Betty on fiddle and Dave Betty on drums round out the lineup. You can ask them about that name after the show. Ladies and gentlemen, Buckshot Betty.
Thank you.
song went too fast for everybody. Woo! I'm scaring my own.
Gorgeous, right? Pat wrote that song. He grew up in Louisiana, somewhere near the Calcasieu. I've never been.
What's up?
I mean, I've been to Louisiana, but not to the river now.
Any Cajuns in the house?
No.
I don't waste a call.
No.
I'm the only one representing.
Well, we're good, Pat.
Thank you.
y'all. We want to thank Arts Wake Forest for having us out here. As it was mentioned earlier, this is the first of a series of six Sundays. Oh my gosh, I gotta look at my notes. Yep. Six Sundays this spring. So for those of you who went to public schools in Durham County, that means there's five more. So you should come back out, check their website, and see what's up. Also, we have some merchandise. One of the red tents back here, we have some, hey, Llewellyn. We have some t-shirts and some CDs and some stickers and some fun conversation. Llewellyn is funny. I appreciate she and Nora coming out and manning that for us, or woman in that for us. Person named for us. That's thirsty.
This has extra strings, so I just won't use it.
What?
Oh, it's a Johnny Cash.
Thank you. Wow, thank you.
Why am I in the sun?
You got that hat and those sunglasses, dog. And the water.
You're very prepared for your station.
This next song is called Restless Mind.
It's true.
It has a line about a humble home, which also happens to be
the name of our album?
The name of our new album. Buckshot Day, Humble Home.
It's true.
Which you can get right up there for only $10.
Only $10.
Has 11 songs. That is less than $1 a song.
And a surprise.
And a... Don't tell anybody. There's a hidden track. See if you can find it.
Do not... Whatever you do, don't listen to it backwards. Don't.
How do you listen to a CD?
Hard on the needle.
A second as the guitar tech. How did I do?
for a guitar tech.
It pays nothing. Scent water. Thank you.
Thank you. I wrote that one. It's sad. All my songs are sad. I'm super counseling. Maybe that's why they put me on the sunny side.
That's right.
Hey, maybe that's why they put me on the sunny side. Thank you. All right, Dan wrote this one.
He's gonna play a little Nana Puddin'. We call this SOS. There is nothing in the song that has anything to do with its title, except for one night when we were working it up, I don't know, 4 years ago, Dan. Dan wrote it quickly because he likes to put things on like those ginormous whiteboards so that we all know what we're supposed to be doing. And so he just wrote 50s, because it sort of has a 50s sound, and it looked like SOS, and so that's the name of the song now. Dan is very creative that way.
The last time I played electric guitar live, I accidentally knocked over my entire amp and rig, and everything came crashing down, so I will endeavor to do my best not to do that.
That's quite his way back there.
That was not an accident.
He kicked it over.
So everyone stand back. Probably all have protective eyewear on today. Oh, no, you didn't get the memo.
Oh,
Thank y'all so much.
Let's speed it up.
You know, you're the best guitar tech on this stage right now.
Oh, shucks.
Yeah.
You're so sweet, Pat.
Thank you.
So all of the songs that you'll hear us play, well, all the songs that we do, are ones that one or the other of us are a collaboration. We've written ourselves, except for this one. We sort of stole it. Good luck finding it anywhere, but yeah, we really did sort of steal it. We sort of stole it.
Nobody had to know.
Does anybody have one of those black wands? No? No? Nobody?
This is real.
Thank you. is when we are supposed to take a little break. So you guys go check out the food vendors over here. I haven't seen what's there, but I heard something that sounded really yummy a while ago. There are some t-shirts and CDs and stickers back there. There's information about Wake Forest, the town, and again, Arts Wake Forest. We really appreciate you guys having us out here. They have some information back there, and they're going to walk around, and if you guys can support them, they do all of this for free. There's 6 weeks of music on Sundays that these guys put on, so show them a little bit of appreciation and support so that this can go on for summers to come, or springs to come, I guess. All right, we're Buckshot Betty, and we will be back, whether you like it or not.
Just keep that applause going. Aren't they terrific? We were just saying what a perfect soundtrack this was for a Sunday afternoon, right? Well, I'm with Arts Wake Forest. Just wanted to remind you, to add on to what Kim said, we're going to be having volunteers coming through the crowd. These concerts are free, and they have been for 25 years, but they're not free to produce. We can't very well ask musicians of this caliber to volunteer their time. So please be as generous as your conscience allows as our volunteers walk through the crowd. And the band will see you again in about 20 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you so much. So just to show you some of God's roots, we're going to play a banjo song. I used to make fun of banjos, and then I started seeing this guy that plays one, so I still make fun of banjos.
This is always a song I know with banjo, so who is it?
What?
I'm saying I know this is a stretch.
So again, I'll let you guys know that we have some t-shirts and some CDs back there. We also have electronic download codes if you're not into an actual physical disc. You can pick all of that up at that red umbrella back there with Lou Ellen. Wave, Lou Ellen. Hey, wave, Nora. Hey. He's a banjo
picker.
They had a banjo in that band? Every daughter, mama's little girl.
I'd like to dedicate that to Sarah Robwood. Everybody you may know. Dexter Robwood, his sister, local musician. We lost her last month to cancer. Big name in Carlboro, played the Blitz active in Richardson. Thanks.
All right. I saw some burgers out there a while ago. They look really good. Save me one. Is that what y'all had? That was good? Yeah. All right, this next song, most of the songs that you're hearing today, Todd wrote. This song is about his granddaddy's sawmill. I actually went to see it. It's kind of gone-ish now, but are you all?
Probably for the best. Thank you, sir. Yeah, I got the saw blade in my house. Y'all want to come through?
It's huge.
Are there any bumpkins in the crowd? Any Ford Chevrolet?
I saw a hand go up back there, but I don't know that it was in
Ford
response.
Ford crowd versus Chevrolet crowd?
No. Okay.
Well, don't get offended, Chevrolet didn't make tractors in the 50s.
This is more of a Hyundai crowd, maybe. I don't know.
The good people of Alabama, thank you.
Grandpa had a sawmill. We love our grandparents up here. I know y'all do too. This song I wrote for my meemaw. This is for you, Llewellyn. It's called Butterbeans.
This song also features Holler and Pat Hicks on the uber rare country uber ukulele.
Rare.
Mahalo.
It's so cute, Pat. It looks all, looks so tiny. This is Ruth. She's going to help me with this next song. Give her a really, really big round of applause. She's the surprise track. Oh no, I guess it's not a surprise anymore. On our album. She came into the studio with us and it was so stinking cute. Wasn't it, Daddy?
Yes, she's my daughter, Bob.
Yes. We don't hold that against her at all. We love us some Ruth. Say hi, Ruth.
Hi.
She just got back from Disney World. She got lots and lots of autographs. Two from Pluto. I don't know. I guess I didn't know kids really dug Pluto that much, but what do I know? But she did get Cinderella, right? A couple other princesses. Mickey and Minnie. Yeah.
Ruth told me earlier today that if she were in this band, she would want to be the dancer. So this is her chance to be the dancer and to help out on a special line.
Yes.
Let me get there.
Yes. You said you're leaving.
Down. Sometimes it hurts so good.
made a lot of trips downtown and over Lake Pontchartrain in New Orleans. And it always missed, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's good, because I introduced the wrong song sometimes. So NOLA stands for New Orleans, Louisiana, for eight or so of you that don't know. It's a wonderful, cool city. And this is a song I wrote just saying so. That will say it with me. I'm gonna gamble. Who that?
Who that?
Yeah!
That's what I'm I'm talking about. Thank you, sir.
Boy. He's so excited.
What's happening?
Sure. I want to bone on the same health care.
Sir, you can leave and I'll refund you your money.
That's somebody that knows controlling me. It has to be. Stand with you leaving and they're going to fall for anything.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we've got a couple more for you. Dan's got Nanner Pudding again. That's what we call his yellow guitar.
I thought we call that Nanner Pudding.
Nanner Pudding. I can't believe how gorgeous it is.
What? This is a little bit more rocking. This is more Birds-esque, not meant to imply that we were as talented as the Birds.
Yeah.
Just that it jangles.
I was alive in the 60s when the Birds were at the peak, so they kind of influences your sound.
Oh.
It's called More Yesterdays Than Tomorrows. Which is true for most of us up here. He's just a baby. We're going to see you out with one more song. It's called Todd's Song. Thanks so much for coming out and sharing this gorgeous day with us. We've had a blast. I hope you have too.
Thanks, Mom.
And again, I'll remind you that the guys that put this all together up here at this white tent, check them out. They've got 5 more Sundays with music for you. And it's free, and hopefully it's gorgeous like this for all of them. And help them out so they can keep this thing going. And then up here, red tent, if you're looking for t-shirts, and I know that you are, Carol, model. See? Gorgeous, right? Absolutely gorgeous. 10 stinking dollars. That's all. That's all. That's all. Dan, do you have one? You
can't beat that.
You can't beat that. No. No.
Next and week's show is Southern Culture on the Steeds. You can't get no bigger local than that.
That's true. That's true.
And if you want to see where we're playing next, you can check us out at buckshotbetty.com or on Facebook at BuckshotB.
BuckshotB. Yes, it's true. Or you can give us your email up there where Llewellyn is sitting. We have a clipboard. You can give us your email and we'll let you know. We'll send you a message and say, hey, we're doing this. And y'all can say, hey, I'm going to that. Because why wouldn't you?
That is absolutely correct. Absolutely, positively.
Yeah.
Too far to see a twilight show, like the Charles and the Angels, as the kids on with a job.